Hello students, welcome all of you. This is lecture number 13 of the topic Surface Chemistry on class 12. This is a continuous lecture from previous lecture 12. In this segment we have discussing about the classification of colloidal solution on the basis of nature of number of particles. On the basis of number of particles, colloidal solution can be classified into three types. First one is, that is multi-molecular collides. Then large number of atom or molecule combined together dissolve molecule into the dispersion liquid and forms the solution in the form of colloidal range is called multi-molecular collides. Examples, the sulfur are in 8 acid form, acid dissolve into dispersion medium. Like second example is gold soul. Gold soul, gold is a molecule which dissolve into dispersion phase, dispersion medium, then it also prepared by this method. Second type of examples is that of macro molecular collides. In this type of collider solution, then large number of molecule having large molecular mass dissolve into dispersion medium to form colloidal source. Such type of collides is called macro molecular collides. Example, like protein polythene, starch, etc. These having large molecular mass, then dissolve into dispersion medium and forms colloidal. So such type of colloidal is known as macromolecular colloidal. Now we have discussed the third type of colloidal source, known as associated colloids.
I think third type one is associated colloids.
Some of the substances, some of the substances having low concentration, but behave as a strong electrolyte, but at high concentration, these high concentration, there is aggregation takes place, and this aggregation leads to forms misses. This type of colloids are known as associated colloids. Example like soap, dissolve into water, aqueous solution. First of all, what is the general formula of soap? RCOOL. Soap, the chemical name of soap is sodium salt of fatty acid. Like R value, R is greater than equal to 12, more than 12, 12 and more than 12. This is the example of soap, ionic soap and detergent is sodium salt of sulfonate ion. Detergent is known as sodium salt of sulfonate ions. That is important. In this case, R also greater than equal to 12. Let us take example of soap and detergent. Sodium stearate, sodium salt of stearate ions. The general formula is C17H35COON. Its chemical name is sodium salt of stearate ion. This is a soap. Whereas detergent, one example is there, detergent CH3CH2 11 OSO2 NA. This one is called sodium salt of sulfonate. This is example of, now we have discussed the mechanism of flow as well as detergent. Mechanism of flow, as we know, soap, that is RCOONA. In this case, in soap there are two parts. One part is hydrophilic. This is the hydrocarbon. R stands for hydrocarbon. This is the hydrophobic. And this is the sodium carboxylate anion. This is hydrophilic. Sodium carboxylate anion. This is the hydrophilic. Then soap dissolves into water molecules. This is the hydrocarbon. In this case, hydrocarbon do not interact with water molecule. This one, sodium carboxylate part, which interact with water molecules. How can soap work in water? First of all, when soap dissolves on the dispersion phase, the hydrocarbon part, that is hydrocarbon part, that is R, lying on the surface. Whereas the carboxylate ion surrounded on the surface of hydrocarbon part. Then at high concentration there is aggregation takes place, aggregation takes place and forms misses due to hydrophilic part pulls out the water molecules and removes the dirty substances and latter deposited inside the bulb. This is the cleansing action. This is known as cleansing action. So, the center which contains, that is a hydrophilic, hydrophobic part, that is R. Let us take example C17H3. This is the hydrocarbon part of stearate ion. Sodium salt of stearate and this one surrounded the vessel formation where soap dissolve into water molecules. Its surrounding this is the sodium hydrophilic part, CoN. This one is called sodium carboxylate ions. Then soap dissolve into water molecules, it forms bases. How can the cleansing action of soap? In center surface of, this is the surface on the water molecules, the center which contains the hydrophilic part, hydrophobic part, that is hydrocarbon, and its surrounding sodium carboxylate ion. When soap dissolve into water, the water molecule interact with hydrophilic part along with dirty substance, so that this dirty substance pulls out from along with water molecules, and our cloths clean, and later on these particles settle down on the bottom of the container. Now we have to discuss the other topic in next